Welcome everybody, welcome to the term of illumination. Everything here is about the realm we live in, the story you're not told, you've never been taught. So I'm exposing all the truths that haven't been taught to the people, and how we've all been misled, misunderstood everything. You're either lied to or at best misinterpreted information has been brought down the lines, down through history, and we've all just come to believe it blindly. It's called blind faith. Should be renamed blind ignorance, see? There's an opposite right there. So I'm doing this video, it's connected to one of the videos I just did recently about Christ the Son, you see? And all this other stuff just comes in, and how I mentioned there's no beginning and no end. So I mentioned Alpha and Omega. So everybody just seems to think, oh, Alpha is the beginning, Omega is the end. Oh, Omega is the end. They don't realize it means there is no beginning and there is no end. So when you come to the end of the Bible, John, then into Revelations, that's the end of a cycle, but it keeps going for the next constellation. It's worth moving, isn't it? There's no beginning and no end. Well, you could say there is a beginning, sort of, but it just keeps going. But as far as man is concerned, Earth has always been here. So there's no beginning. But there's a one-off story. But that's connected with man's awakening as well. But let's not get carried away. Here is something that's totally misinterpreted, okay? John 13. O Lord, the hope of Israel, all that forsake thee shall be ashamed, and they that depart from me shall be written in the earth, because they have forsaken the Lord, the fountain of living waters. So the average guy is going to think, well, you know, pity those people. But it's the reverse, the opposite. These are the lucky ones. O Lord, the hope of Israel. Israel's Isis, Ra, the sun, and Elohim is the God, godly. It's the spiritual enlightenment. These are the enlightened ones. Become their Israel, okay? Because Isis, the moon, Ra, the sun, Elohim, godly, God within man, okay? All that forsake thee shall be ashamed. Ash aimed. Ash aimed. This is the Milky Way, the fiery, the dragon. And that's what the Milky Way is. It's the alignment. My videos have been talking about the alignment of the Milky Way. Okay? In this situation, I haven't got a drawing. So we'll just call it the Sundown Dilemma. But you haven't. You have a Milky Way, like this actually, it comes around like this, and the Northern Hemisphere has one. There's this alignment. The Milky Way, it's like you could call it the tunnel, the tube, ash, shamed. This boils down to fire and all that, and these ancient stories like the Iliad and stuff, or even it's this tropical gap, you see, the two, you've got the Northern Hemisphere here, okay, the Southern. You might have to check out my other videos if you don't understand all this. So this tropical gap here, you've got the Milky Way that comes over to the center here. What are we saying? All that forsake me, forsake the ashamed. So it's the Milky Way alignment. There's an alignment there. So, excuse me. So fire and brimstone and all that stuff, but it's all about awakening in this alignment overhead in your arc of horizon. So it has to happen up here. Now, so that's the S in aimed is an alignment, aiming, ash, fire, whatever. It's a good alignment. It's a good thing anyway, okay? And you talk about forsake. All that forsake thee shall be ashamed. Forsake forsake thee.
Well, forsake. You've got forsake in. Forsaken me. Forsake in me. Now, for, you can go back to the Deshet, is it?
The Egyptian symbol. What's that thing called? Looks like this. It's got the four things here. And people seem to think that represents the backbone. Is it the Deshet? And it sort of does. But there's four frequencies, okay? There's four tones or four sounds. And this is what they're referring to over here too. Four, saken. So man has hit his four divine notes or tones. And also in creation we have the four winds. Because the four winds that create the vortex at the center of creation. And those four sounds or notes or whatever, bang, created our realm, our whole realm. It's perfection. Okay? So man has reached his four and sake in him. In him. Me. Sake in me. The Lord. Okay? Then you got sake, and then it sounds a lot like sack. Okay? Sack. This is all about sacking. It's related to the sacking. See? The sack. The hanging, the cross, died on the cross. It's all the divine moment in a man's, in a time, in man's hour, the meaning to life. So he shall be ashamed, and they that depart from me shall be written in the earth. So there's the alignment. You've gone through it. You were the lucky one in here. Then it moves on, goes out of an alignment, goes down. So there's the alignment up there. Then you pass out. It all starts warping away. If you know anything about star trail photography, if you're not on a dead north to south meridian, it's all just warping away like this when you're trying to video star trail photography. So, written in the earth. So, what do we find written in the earth? What are on the clay tablets? There's no BS on those clay tablets. All those clay tablets hold the records. Our history, that's what you call written in earth, okay? So it's the good stuff, it's the good event. So see how this is the totally opposite to what, you know, we read this as the opposite to what it really is. Because they have forsaken the Lord, the fountain of living waters. It's all about the water, moving the waters, the flood, the Nile. There's the Nile in the celestial, the overall celestial creation story is the tropical gap. There, okay? And at the same time I'm doing this, is it pops a video about this place on Earth, it might be Australia or somewhere, where there's these two ridges of a couple of islands or something come together close like this, and the water rushes through it. Because it builds up high on one side and then rushes through it. It's the same thing that's going on here. The field rushing through there. This is the southern hemisphere rotation. Star trail rotation you'll get on your meridian, north to south, and there's the northern one. They look the same because we're there, so it looks equal. We're looking at it as the observer there, but overall on a whole you've got a smaller northern hemisphere as opposed to the southern. The southern is 33.3 degrees larger. That's why we get this sums and a lemma like this. Okay, I'll move on. So I'll read this. Jesus had just proclaimed that he was the fountain of living waters. As one more aside, then Jesus returns to his teaching of the multitude in the temple. So you've got to remember, when he goes to the temple, he's going up in here at night asleep by saying, I am the light of the world. This was the very morning that the four great lamps, There's the four great lamps again. Of the court and the temple, which were called the light of the world, were being extinguished after being kept lit for an entire week. Oh, okay. So there's another representation of the four frequencies, but the divine person who's had his awakening will get up in the morning and go outside. Everything is so much brighter. All the colors are amazing. And that period lasts for a week. Okay? And then he goes on, Jesus says, or God, whatever, says, whenever you see the rainbow, remember me, or remind you of the day, your day of Passover, because of all those bright colors he saw. You know? So now when you see the rainbow, whoa, he remembers that day. He'll never forget that day anyway, trust me. You will never forget that day. Now, what is the meaning of the Hebrew word hor, H-O-R, as in horizon? Okay, every man has his own personal arc of horizon. The Bible names the meaning of the name hor as who conceives or shows a hill. Does that look like a hill? It is. When he goes up to his mountain, up here in heavenly heaven. Up the mountain, olives. Oliver. What's in an olive? A pip, a stone. What's the son of man? A pineal gland. It's a stone, pretty much. So man's arc of horizon. Horus, horizon. And then we go into Alpha and Omega, what I was mentioning in my last video. Someone said something silly, but he shouldn't have. So you go online, you go, you see this post, and what's he got? Omega. What did I just say about Omega? Alpha and Omega. Never ending. Infinity. There is no beginning. There is no end. Look what they've drawn there. The infinity symbol. I've talked about that in my videos. Omega. What does Omega mean in Bible? The final part, the end. Omega is the 24th and last Greek letter. Put another way, it means the final part, the end part, okay, but it keeps going. You go into the next constellation. So somewhere along the line, should there be another Bible in this next constellation, or is it just go through the same stories in the Bible again till you get to the end of it, the last next constellation? Aquarius, and then at the end times you get the divine arriving again of Horus or Jesus before you go into Revelations, which is the whole divine event. In Revelations, God is using both of these words literally as names for himself. Okay, what is the origin of the word Alpha? The Greek Alpha comes from the Hebrew and Phoenician Aleph, a form of the word for ox, Aleph, possibly because the character resembles an ox's head. Alpha and Omega. Alpha is the beginning. Creation, isn't it, would be the beginning. So where do you do? Where do you go? You go back to creation, it's the center arctic. What have you got here? They look like two horns to me. You've got two horns. And what's in the middle here, or thereabouts? There's the sun. It's the actual sun of creation. We see its image out here in the tropical zone. We can't see anything in here. Well, we see the stars. No, we do, but you don't see that. You don't see pure plasma. We only see the stars when they're cast up into the night sky. So ox, Aleph, possibly because the character resembles an ox head. But somewhere else it says shows an ox head and the sun between it. And yeah, well, the Egyptians do anyway. Show those bull's horns with the big sun here. There's the beginning. That's creation. King James Version. Now we're getting on to David, okay? And David went up by the ascent of the Mount Olivet. He's gone up here again in the spiritual world and wept as he went up and had his head covered and went barefoot, and all the people that was with him covered every man's, and his head, and they went up weeping as they went. Now I've got to remember all that. I can't remember. Well, so let's come back to the sons and dilemma, okay? Because when you start talking, the head's covered. Oh, you go back to this Ark of Horizon again, okay? And David went up by the ascent of the Mount Olivet and wept as he went up and had his head covered, and he went barefoot. So, barefoot. Well, I mean, there's the feet down here. There's your feet of the analemma. That's the head part. There's the feet. This is when their feet are lined next to the Nile, the water, get your feet washed, baptized, whatever. Remember, Jesus, they didn't cut off his legs when he died, because that's the southern part of the analemma. He died on this cross, but the sun still moves, doesn't it, all the way around. Remember, Christ is the sun. He goes back up. They can't cut off his legs. They didn't cut off his legs. When they saw he died, they didn't cut off his legs. Well, legs, feet. Bite thy heel, wound thy head. So bite thy heel. I mean, this could look like a heel in the Achilles, because this whole story here, the tropical zone, is all in the Iliad. It's all about Troy. That's Troy. Here's the Achaeans. Well, they could be Achaeans. These are the Trojans. It's all this. It's this dielectric gap here. And all the energy being created here, which creates our sun image and everything. But that's going into science. Because the whole flipping science book. I mean, Bible is science. So when you're talking about bare feet, he's bearing his feet. Look, they bare their feet. They're bearing together. Two alignments. Bare feet, heads covered. Heads covered. Forgotten what that one was. Oh, well, heads covered is when the sun comes over like this. Because Milky Way, when you see the Milky Way is the back of the sun, right? Because the sun's tucked into your hand like that, into the Milky Way, so it's the back of the sun, right? And then it turns like that. That's the sun. There's the back, there's the Milky Way, right? So you're seeing the back at night, the Milky Way. But when the Milky Way, well, when it comes up here, the sun's facing this way. Its face has fallen, how do they say it? Face down. Fell face down to the ground or something or other. And then as it comes up, It's fully back of the Milky Way, and then as it falls down again, your face falls back onto the ground, because it's daylight. It's going into daylight after your nighttime hours. When that Milky Way goes down there, it becomes daylight. Daylight. Well, the sun's facing that way anyway. Okay? So it swings up like that. You know what I mean? What does he say here? And the people that was with him covered every man his head. So his head, or the face, is covered. You don't see the face, you see the back of the sun is the Milky Way. But when it comes back down here, it's facing down again. And they went up weeping as they went. Weeping. I could have broken that one down, but I've forgotten. I might have. So something to do with moisture. Being maybe the full moon, you get more moisture at the full moon, because this alignment is the time of your full moon, this awakening. David lifted up his eyes and saw the angel of the Lord stand between the earth and the heaven, having a drawn sword in his hand, stretched out over Jerusalem. Then David and the elders of Israel, who were clothed in sackcloth, fell upon their faces. There you go. They fall upon their faces. Up and over, but steep. I mean, a lot of people think I'm just making this stuff up. You know, let's go back to the word sake. We talked about this forsaken. Sake. For the purpose of, in the interest of, in order to achieve or preserve. The couple moved to the coast for the sake of their health. Out of consideration for or in order to help or please someone. I have to make an effort for John's sake. So it's sake. In. Don't misinterpret these words. We've all been taught to misinterpret them. That's basically what I had on the phone there, everybody. Put my glasses on. So, there's your bare foot, bearing feet together. This is bite thy heel, wound thy head. Bite thy heel, bite thy heel. Anyway, so this is what's going on, you see. You get an sundown lemma in the northern hemisphere, and you get one in the southern hemisphere. It's this alignment. And the Milky Way, I should say. At the time of the Milky Way alignment. But you've got to think of the two images. You've got to think of the Milky Way alignment and also the sun's analemma alignment. Because everybody has this on their own arc of horizon. Every man has one. You'll see one. You don't see the whole worldly picture. You just see it within your man's arc of horizon. That's why everything goes down on your horizon. Out of perspective. The earth doesn't curl. That's a bit naff. Be a thick person to think that, but the world's full of them apparently. So understanding this, everything is perpendicular off the arc back to you, okay? The 33% ratio between the northern and southern hemisphere. What have we got here? Hanging. I was going to talk about all these things, but now I've forgotten. Hanging. This is the hanging. So you've got a noose effect. Die on the cross. The sun's crossing at that point too. And you've got a crossing in here in the tropical zone. I've done one on this. It's basically the physics of what's happening in the tropics. The dielectric plates. The capacitor plates and the dielectric gap. What's happening here. How the molecule rises and gets to a point where then there's the connection. But that's a deep, another long story. Didn't cut off his legs. Yeah. They didn't cut off Christ's legs after he died on the cross. Carry on with the seasons. Bite thy heel, wound thy head. Yeah, bite thy heel, wound thy head. I forgot about bite, wound thy head, wound thy head. Well, there is a wounding of the head when the divine event happens. There's a scaling of the top of your head. And this is where the old kippah, or whatever they called it, the Jewish cap they put on there, that's what all that represents. It's covering that spot. You have to hide that spot. And then you've got this on all your dome temples now. And that's all comes from that divine event man goes through. This circle on the top of his head is to do with the pineal gland and what's happening above. Believe it or not, it's flipping a bit freaky. You know, the baby's Fontenoy. It's all soft to the last minute. Well, you wonder why the Jews wear this cap. You probably can't find the answers back in, you know, online or anywhere. But it all stems from that round little cap. And I remember reading in the Bible sometime that when David came down from the mountain, he had his head covered. But I go online now to look, and it's about him going up with his face covered. I couldn't find the part where he comes down with his head covered. What else have we got here? Yeah. No, that's it. Look into this. Now, you can say this represents the backbone. It does, but there's other stories. I could make a big video on this too if I wanted to. How this becomes a half measure for the this area in here between the rib cages. So it's basically a substation, but there's the main ones up the spine, getting the connection. You've got the top frequencies. You've reached those four notes for enlightenment. But there's also the system here where it comes into you at the solar eclipse. It's sitting there waiting to be distributed through your system or something like that. 17 days out at the full moon. Then it activates the thing. And you are reborn. Because you're in the state of mock consciousness. And your alignments and everything. Your divine celestial alignments. You've reached the four notes. And that's your creation story. Same as the Earth. Central Arctic vortex creation, created by the four notes, the four winds. Okay, I'll stop there. I'll start rambling on about all sorts of stuff. Okay, thanks guys.